Students, faculty, family, and friends, good evening and welcome to the graduation ceremony of the Herbert Henry Dow High School Class of 2021. My name is Tess Strebel, and it is an honor to welcome all of you here this evening. Joining me on stage is Dow High Principal Ted Davis, our staff speaker, Mr. Alex Carapas, our student speakers, Jason Laflow and Evan Trotterite, and our 2021 Commencement Committee, Ryan Erdman, Emily Danielson, Jada Gardner, Charlie Hunkins, and myself. We would like to take a moment to acknowledge the Midland Public Schools Superintendent Michael Sherrow and the school board members, Mr. Scott McFarland, Mr. Philip Rausch, Ms. Pam Singer, Mr. John Lauterbach, Ms. Lynn Baker, Mr. Brad Blasey, and Mr. John Hatfield, who will be presenting the diplomas to the class of 2021. At this time, we ask you to please turn off or silence all electronic devices. This ceremony would not be possible if it wasn't for the men and women who have fought and continue to fight for our country. So at this time, we ask you to please rise, remove your caps, and turn your attention to the flag as we are led in recording by the Dow High Band in proudly playing our national anthem. Please be seated.
Our first student speaker is someone who has been one of my closest friends going all the way back to the days at Cook Elementary School. He and I often reminisce about the times we would spend outside pretending we were horses running around, or baseball players running around our imaginary diamond. That is one of my fondest memories of junior year. All jokes aside, he has been extremely involved and successful in the Dow High Journalism program. His sophomore year, he was selected to be the sports editor of the school newspaper, The Update, and earned the title of editor-in-chief for his senior year. He was also a founding member of Bolt Media, the school's video communications class, responsible for the virtual announcements that you have probably seen this year. He has also been a leader in producing sports live streams throughout our high school career. He is a member of the National Student Press Association Honor Roll, and also a member of the National Scholastic Press Association Student Journalist Staff. Next year, he plans to attend Michigan State University and study sports journalism. Ladies and gentlemen, Jason Laflow.
Thank you, Charlie. Well, class of 2021, here we are. As I look at all of you today, donning the colors of the school that we have all grown to love for the past 4 years, I see a group of resilient young people with promising futures in all sorts of different fields. A group of talented individuals who I know will all follow their dreams to the end of the earth. I know all of this to be true due to one simple fact. This class has faced more challenges than likely any other one has in the past few decades. The trials and tribulations that this class, our class, have been subjected to have been extremely real and often extremely troubling. None of that, however, has affected our ability to adapt and overcome, oftentimes making things even better than they were before. Despite the fact that the unfortunate circumstances of this world have taken so many of our senior year experiences away from us, we are all still here today to take the first step towards the rest of our lives. I am extremely grateful and humbled to be a member of the class of 2021, and all of you should be too. I'll get to why in a second, but first, I have something to tell you. I am often somewhat pessimistic. Sure, I may not appear that way on the outside, but I tend to first look at the drawbacks of any given situation before analyzing the benefits. With that being said, my pessimism has often led me to grow annoyed with senior classes of years past without sound reason. To me, it always seemed like high school graduation was really not the biggest deal in the world. From the outside, looking in, it appeared to my younger self that high school was just a stepping stone in the grand scheme of life, and moving on from it was just a futile matter of going through the motions. What I misunderstood when I had these thoughts, however, is that every single graduating class that has come out of H.H. Dow High School has been extremely unique, and that there is cause for celebration when you are finally able to change the tassels and toss the caps. I've come to recognize this over my 4 years in high school, where I've been very fortunate to find my passion in journalism, telling the stories of others through whichever medium I can. Through being the editor-in-chief of The Update and a founding member of Bolt Media, I've found over the years that people often have so much more to them than what meets the eye. Little did I know that among us, we have computer programmers building solutions to help better the world, business minds who have their own successful small businesses surging the local economy when it needs it most, and philanthropists who put the interests of the less fortunate above all else. While it may have seemed to my naive self that all the classes before us were just a hodgepodge of teenagers excited to finally escape the grasp of high school life, I've come to realize that each and every person has a story to tell, and it is just as important to the world as anybody else's. To turn the tables a little bit and tell you my story, I'll tell you that, from as early as I can remember, I have been grateful to be alive. I am a cancer survivor. At the ripe age of just one, I was diagnosed with neuroblastoma. I have no recollection of this other than the frequent trips I made to Ann Arbor in the subsequent years until I was declared cancer-free. But from that point on, my parents let it be known to me that I was extremely fortunate. Not only did I win the lottery on life when I was born into a loving family with a roof over my head and food on the table, but I was lucky enough to win a battle against an enemy that was trying to take all of that away from me. I stand here today extremely grateful to have the privilege to be alive and to use the opportunities that I have been given for the greater good. I tell this story for a very intentional reason. In a way, we all have won the lottery on life. Although everybody here is standing on a different rung of the socioeconomic ladder, and some, unfortunately, are less privileged in our society than others due to race, ethnicity, religious background, and other factors that they simply can't control, we have all nonetheless been extremely fortunate to find ourselves right here, right now, graduating from one of the greatest high schools in the state of Michigan and knocking on the door of grand futures that will undoubtedly change our lives and society for the better. We all, too, have had an enemy attempting to take all of this away from us. I've made a conscious effort not to mention said enemy by name, and I'll continue to do so. But the grim reality is that this enemy has taken well over 500,000 American lives, and the chances are that one of those has been somebody you knew. It has otherwise ravaged the lives of every single person on this planet and robbed us, and every other senior class around the world, for that matter, from any sort of typical senior year. Look, I understand that some of you may think that you have your lives all planned out from the minute you exit this stadium, but a lot of you do not, and there's really no shame in that. Whatever you end up doing, though, make it worthwhile. Don't take for granted the opportunities that you have been given as someone living in a developed nation with a high school diploma. All of you sitting in front of me have a purpose, whether you believe it or not. For some of you, I understand high school was terrible, whether it be academically, socially, or otherwise, and you're glad to get out of here. Some of you will miss high school, however, and reminisce of a time when you were shielded from the harsh realities of the real world. Most of you, I imagine, are somewhere in between. But for all of you, no matter where you stand, I have good news. Your new life begins now. What you do when you leave these grounds is completely within your control, and you should use that to do whatever makes you happy. For some of you, that means going to college. For others, it means going into the workforce or enlisting in the military. No matter what, I know that all of you have been given the tools to be successful in your own unique ways. Who knows? Maybe one of you, planning to go into the medical field, will end up saving the life of a little kid like me, who, despite the odds of everything, went on to address his class at commencement. But it wasn't just the medical professionals who saved my life, however. It was the community. I was given an opportunity to succeed from exemplary teachers, impassioned peers, and a supportive school system that I had along the way. For those looking to go into education, I hope that you can be a source of inspiration for generations to come. But for all of you, no matter what your plans may be, I hope that you can understand that I was saved by the kindness put forth by the people of this world. And I hope that no matter what life throws at you, you can be one of those people, realizing that you have won the lottery on life, and you better not take that for granted. Thank you, and congratulations, class of 2021.
Our next speaker is the most musically talented student I know. He considers himself proficient on 8 different instruments and is currently working on number 9. He represents himself in band, choir, and orchestra, one of only 2 kids at Dowd to do so. His genuine and bubbly personality makes him a favorite to have in the classroom and is loved by his teachers and students alike. On top of that, he's a 3-sport varsity athlete. He will study theater next fall at Northwestern University, and I'll bet you money he'll be on Broadway one day. Without further ado, please welcome Evan Trotter-Wright.
Thank you, Ryan. Parents, staff, and students, good evening. For those of you that don't know me, I am Evan Trotter-Wright, and on behalf of the entire senior class of 2021, wow, we did it. We graduated. We made it through terribly tough teachers and tests. We made it through spare spaghetti soaking in the soap dispenser. And we made it through forced, awful, and obvious attempts at alliteration. There's your rhetoric for today. We made it through sports seasons, exams, and performances. We also made it through heartbreaks, disappointments, and sadness. And not to mention, you know, the whole pandemic thing. We made it through high school. It's hard to find words to describe this feeling. For most, if not all of us, this is a day we've been thinking about for a long time. Some of you have been yearning for it since day one. You're wishing I would just get on with it so you can grab your piece of paper and peace out. Others have been dreading it with your whole hearts. Some of you could go either way and really just want to go back to bed where it's warm. Me, D, all of the above. Or E, if I want to be one of those teachers that puts 5 multiple choice answers on the test. But that's not the point. The point is, no matter how you feel about it, high school is over. We're all going to be moving on in our lives, no matter where we're going, what we're doing, who we're seeing, and all of the other 5 W's. This is the end of our high school career. As we all begin our journeys into the unknown, frozen too deeply in our routines, stress, and excitement, it's important to take a breath and stop. Before moving on to all of our glorious futures, we should take time to reflect on our pasts. I can't remember my first day of high school. Heck, pretty much my entire freshman year is a blur, but certain messages got drilled into my head that I couldn't forget them even if I wanted to. But they got me through high school, and I hope they can help you all get through whatever comes next. The first example is get involved. Looking back, this quote feels a little unfair, though. It could be interpreted as get busy. What about people with jobs or lots of homework, stuff like that? They don't have time to get busy. It can seem kind of hard to find time to get involved. So here's my advice. You don't have to do it all at once. The point of getting involved isn't to say, oh, look at me, I was on 16 separate pages of the yearbook. No, the point is trying things. The point is saying yes in situations where you normally would have said no. It's learning about yourself, your interests, your passions, and the world through the interests and passions of others. It's about making connections, and it's about having fun. High school is only 4 years. We all have the rest of our lives ahead of us. you don't have to do it all at once. I'm going to change the quote just a little bit. Instead of get involved, try this. Get passionate. Trademark Evan Trotter Wright. If you say it, you owe me a penny. I will know. But seriously, in the future, get passionate. In your future, don't do things to check them off of boxes. Do things because you care about them. Whether you waltz into your future like Cinderella before midnight, or stumble into it like somebody playing as the imposter for the first time in Among Us, get passionate. Do things you love and love them. The other quote that comes to mind, I'm sure you could all guess if I gave you a second. You know, in fact, I'm so confident, I want you all to say it with me, okay? So just say what you think the quote is on three, all right? Ready? One, two, three. Every day is a great day to be a chart. Close enough. You get it. I couldn't count how many times I've heard this on all of my fingers and toes. So at least 21. But that's still a lot. But have you ever stopped to think about what it really means? Being a Charger is great. We wear green and gold, we cheer on our sports teams, we support our arts departments, and we love beating the other team. But being a Charger is so much more than that. Being a Charger is more than just school spirit, it's having spirit. It's about living life to the fullest and embracing everything that comes at you. It's about loving life and loving others. Not just loving other Chargers, but loving everyone. Being a Charger is about being kind. It's about being adaptable, flexible, intelligent. As Chargers, we look at a challenge and we say, bring it on. We put our heels together, toes apart, throw our shoulders back, hold our heads high, and charge straight into it. Looking back over the last 4 years, especially at the last 1.5, we did just that. And now, here we are. So, no matter where you're going or what you're doing next year and beyond, whether you'll be a Spartan, Wolverine, Pioneer, Cardinal, Wildcat, or a Bulldog, or an employee, or someone who serves the country, or anything in between, be a Charger. Thank you, Dow High, and all of you for the best 4 years of my life. Congratulations.
It is with great honor to give all of you a glimpse about our next guest speaker, who happens to be a teacher at Dow High School. He currently teaches freshman world history and sociology, but regardless of academics and teaching, he strives to interact and build significant relationships with all students just within his 4 years at Dow High. Mr. Karapas started his teaching career as an intern at Jefferson Middle School after graduating from Alma College with a degree in secondary education, history, and social studies. As the class of 2021 began their high school career, Mr. Karapas started his own journey of committing to excellence through Dow High. And ever since then, he has been with this class every step of the way. He has been an advocate for school spirit and probably the most energetic, enthusiastic, and fun teacher you'll ever meet. Besides teaching, Mr. Karapas has been involved with a numerous of school activities, ranging from DJing school dances to being a coach for both golf and basketball. I personally got the opportunity to interact with Mr. K on a daily basis when he decided to help coach the girls' varsity basketball team. Not only did he bring positive and fun energy into the gym, but was also one of the first people to express how much he cared about each and every one of us like we were his own. His compassion and caring attitude is going to carry on for many years ahead, and even though this is the end of our journey together, nothing will ever be able to replace the relationships and memories made during our time at Dow High. With all that being said, it is my pleasure to welcome a longtime teacher and friend of the class of 2021, Mr. Karapas.
Married, and the wedding rehearsal is today. And for those of you who know, I do not run the show at home. So it was a battle that I lost, and I'm currently at the wedding rehearsal. but I just want you guys to know how much I really wanted to be here and give you this speech in person. Second of all, as you guys know, I'm not very good at sticking to a script. I've never put in a lesson plan, seeing Let It Go from Frozen or Jump on Desk. It kind of just happens. I do what feels right. And what feels right now is to go off script a little bit. And just let you guys know how hard I worked on the speech because I wanted it to be absolutely perfect. I would be driving in the car or laying in bed in the middle of the night. Hello, everybody. Driving in the car or laying in bed in the middle of the night and think of something and say, hey, I need to include that in my speech. And then I would go to write it down and it never seemed right. I ultimately struggled to put into words how much you guys meant to me. So if you're gonna get anything out of this speech, I want it to be that I love you guys. So let's get started with the speech. Congratulations, you made it. I'm sure I speak for everyone here in attendance today when I say that I'm extremely proud of each and every one of you. You overcame unimaginable obstacles to get here, and your perseverance is truly inspiring. To say that I'm honored to be speaking at graduation this year is an understatement. I mean, don't get me wrong, obviously simply being asked by, you know, the representatives of any graduating class to speak is an enormous honor. But honestly, tears were brought to my eyes when I was asked to speak during your graduation. This is because your graduating class holds such a special place in my heart. For those of you who do not know, my career began with them, with you guys. If you ever had me in class or I coached you in sports or maybe just through a conversation in the hall, you remember me telling you on multiple occasions that I considered you family, and I truly do. Thank you for the memories. I and the rest of the Dow community will miss you dearly. As I thought about you all and reflected on your high school careers, there were two lessons that came to mind that I hope you've taken away from Dow High. The first being the sacredness of time. A quote that stuck with me from high school is there's a reason God limits our days to make each one precious. I'm sure you're sitting here today thinking how fast your high school careers went by, but it's important to remember that that is why they're so special. You know better than anyone that your life can turn upside down when you least expect it. So please, cherish all of life's moments and don't take anything for granted. Secondly, it is the importance of building and maintaining strong relationships. When you look back in high school and all you accomplished, I guarantee you won't remember the grade you got on every test or the score of every game. But you will remember the bonds you formed with your peers, your teachers, and your coaches through success and defeat. Although it is important to work hard towards your goals, keep in mind that people will remember you by how you made them feel, and your legacy will be defined by the relationships you build and the lives that you impact. Lastly, I will leave you with a challenge. I challenge you to learn the difference between doing well and doing good, other than the grammar. I want you all to do well in your future endeavors, whether that be in higher education, your professional careers, or so on. But more importantly, I want you all to do good. Make the world a better place, one Dow High graduate at a time. It can be as simple as giving a smile to a stranger as you walk by. Take the time to look up from our phones, listen to one another, and create a chain reaction of acts of kindness every single day. Congratulations, class of 2021. You've done well. Now go do good. Thank you.
I'm honored to be here tonight representing the staff at H.H. Dow High School and the Midland Public Schools District as we celebrate the class of 2021. I'd like to start tonight by congratulating our Charger families. Thank you for sharing with us a class of individuals whom we are proud to graduate today. Thank you to Dow Diamond for assisting with the format to help make the commencement ceremony possible. Thank you to the Midland Public Schools Board of Education for attending tonight and receiving this graduating class. I'd also like to take a moment to thank our amazing Dow High staff. Our staff is a dedicated group of exceptional educators who consistently go above and beyond for our school. Thank you, staff, for all you do for the Dow High community. It is my privilege to acknowledge all military veterans, active duty, and all members of the class of 2021 who will leave to serve in the armed forces. The Dow High family salutes all of you and extends a heartfelt thank you as we celebrate your commitment to serve our country. I would like to ask you to please stand and be recognized. Today we will graduate the 51st class of H.H. Dow High School. This class of 315 graduates has persevered and overcome obstacles unlike no other graduating class in the history of Dow High. This class is exceptional not just because of the adversity they fought through, but what they've accomplished during their high school career. The commencement speech by the principal is typically focused on all the activities and accomplishments throughout the school year. As we all know, the last year and a half have been anything but typical for this graduating class. In the last 15 months, you've battled a pandemic, a 500-year flood, had most of your traditional high school experiences taken away or drastically modified. Not to mention all the safety precautions you've embraced as being normal to receive your education face-to-face. I sent out a survey to our staff this year asking for one word they felt best described what it meant to be a Charger. As I read through their responses, I couldn't help but think of this graduating class. Instead of focusing on many of your traditional statistics, I will instead talk about a few characteristics that have made this group special. The first word which fits this class is resilience. To say this class of 2021 has been resilient would be an understatement. You've lost most typical high school traditions previous graduating classes have enjoyed. The dances, cheering in student sections, in-person competitions, performance and activities were changed to virtual. And I'm sure there were many times throughout the year where you were disappointed or felt, well, this is just unfair. Yet, you remain positive, always trying to have the best day ever. You were able to find a way to compete, celebrate, and perform, even if it was in the virtual world. As you always do, you excelled no matter what the format. Determination. This class was determined to make their senior year as, quote, normal as possible. Even though your year consisted of temperature checks, masks, desk shields, sanitizer, quarantine list, and the shift from face-to-face to virtual, you were determined to exceed expectations in the classroom, and that's exactly what you accomplished. We recently received news that H.H. Dow High School has been awarded a silver medal and ranked in the top 4% of all high schools in the state of Michigan by U.S. News and World Report. And it's because of your determination we were able to receive this amazing recognition. Kindness. This class was kind enough to say good morning and thank you as you walked through the temperature screening each morning. You participated in Kindness Week, focusing on gratitude, laughter, goal-setting activities, and mindfulness. You followed this up by participating in Charity Week, collecting coins and cans to provide for the less fortunate in our community. When our community was hit hard by the flood, you rallied around those who were devastated and to lend a helping hand. And each day, you worked on keeping Dow High a place where students felt safe and accepted. Chargers, you certainly put the I in kind. These are just a few of the qualities I've seen in abundance from the Dow High School class of 2021. For it's these characteristics, resilience, determination, and kindness that make your class special. They are the building blocks of a foundation that will help you as you move on to the next phase of your life. As we come to an end, I will humbly offer you this advice. Don't ever give up. If you've learned anything this year, tough times don't last forever. It would have been easy for you to have given up during the last 15 months. Instead, you looked at it as a challenge, you stayed the course, never losing focus of your goals. As you leave here tonight, headed for your next journey, challenge the status quo, don't be afraid to ask for help, and don't ever give up. Oh, and one more thing, Chargers. Don't forget to always make it the best day ever. Now I would like to introduce Mr. John Hatfield, a member of our Midland Public Schools Board of Education. If you would please come to the podium.
Thank you, Principal Davis. On behalf of the Midland Public Schools Board of Education, it is my pleasure and honor to accept the 51st H.H. Dow High School graduating class, the class of 2021.
At this time, we'd ask for the very first row to please stand, and then we're going to head down there towards Mr. Jahosky up the ramp to receive your diploma covers.
Mitch Atkins, Catherine Alt, Justice Ball, Gabriel Bannonman, Anna Barnes, Lincoln Beringer, Rafton Bartlett, Gabriel Bateman, Lucas Bateman, Hayden Baus, Caitlin Beckard, Adit Biju, Allison Binkley, Molly Birch, Ryan Bishop, Christina Bixby, Colton Bogazewski, Jacob Bowl, Elijah Booth, Anna Bradford, Caleb Brensky, Tristan Brewer, Aaron Brown, Jackson Brown, Dylan Bryant. Andrew Budd. Joshua Burr. Josiah Burr. Liam Callahan. Ryan Capp. Ethan Karn. Annika Cedarstrom. Grace Che. Catherine Chaffee. Griffin Chapman. Nolan Chappell. Michelle Charles Anele. Kylie Chartier. Alec Kronowski. Jacob Clough. Brooke Cochran. Mattia Cox. Micah Damocles. Kelly Dang. Emily Danielson. Ethan Dostick. Joseph Dauenhauer. Zoe Dauphiny. Amanda Davis. Maggie Dean. Jacob DeLombardi. Madeline DeLong. Josh V. Desai. Leah DeWeaver. Colin Deal. London Dingman. Kayla Dominowski. Josh Doty. Max Doty. Matthew Douglas. Madeline Drake. Gavin Dahl. Anna Early. Samuel Eisenman. Kiara Ekdahl. Selma Elsadani. Ryan Erdman. Jack Erickson. Jerome Essenmacher. Nicholas Fabiano. Nicholas Fang. Laura Fawcett. Lotta Furquette. Aiden Ferreter. Caleb Flint. Peter Ford. Connor Forshee. Catherine Frank. Cameron Friedel. Brianna Fuller. Brandon Ferez. Michaela Galloway. William Gandy. Jada Garner. Morgan Gary. Jack Gavin. Evan Gibo. Ann Ginsburg. Alexander Glacken. Jaden Gledhill. Cade Godwin. Sophia Gonzalez. Owen Gornicky. Alexander Griffin.
Mitchell Gross. Ingrid Grossman. Gabrielle Gutensberger. Gina Guerreri. Cole Hagen. Gabriel Heldorsen. Jacob Hansen. Sonia Hansen. Naisha Hassan. Wyatt Hasselhoon. Samuel Hatfield. Adam Henke. Hayden Hetherington. Jermaine Higgins. Haley Hills. Jenny Ho. Catherine Hodgins. Owen Hook. Kirk Howes II. Maggie Howell. Abigail Humberg. Charlie Hunkins. Aiden Hunt. Shane Hunt. Elise Ingala. Trace Ingle. Benjamin Ismail. Joseph Jackson. Kaylee Jackson. Mackenzie Jacobs. Nolan Janesco. Isabel Jankowski. Maxwell Jankowski. Abigail Jendretska. Suman Joe. Charles Johnson, Faith Johnson, Michelle Johnson, Sydney Johnson, Trent Johnson, Emily Jonas, Matthew Jones, Megan Jones, William Jones, Ty Kenyon, Miller Kepsel, Madison Kerr, Riley Keski, Ayla Khan, Fatima Khan, Hannah Kilbride, Gavin Kilmaster, Joshua Klein, Owen Knight, Caden Kosiski, and Anna Kozel.
Jack Kroll, Alex Kowal, Jason Labby, Jacob Lasko, Brendan Ladwane, Travis Lambert, Alexis Landon, Jason Laplow, Jocelyn Latunsky, Sheridan LeBeau, Jane Lewis, Alexander Liakos, Hannah Loisel, Alvin Lopez, Logan Lorenz, Alante Lowe, Joshua Mack, Giselle Mahoney, Rehan Mangela, Alora Marshall, Easton Martin, Bruce Matthews, Lily Mavis, Logan McCoy, Isabella McDaniel, Marshall McGaw, Victoria McKinney, Ellie McManee, Chloe McVeigh, Joelle Miley, Luke Meyer, Madison Miller, Olivia Miller, Dominic Molsky, Hannah Morey, Roxy Muck, Caitlin Murray, Riley Nelson, Madison Nichols, Brendan Neiman, Joseph Noah, Allison Norman, Brianna Norton Schmidt, David Novak, Connor Ord, Hunter Oberdorf, Jonah Ohl, Adeza Okoro, Dominic Owen, Ross Parfenick, Nicholas Pate, Cameron Patty, Alexander Pavlock, Karis Pendleton, Isabella Perez, Nicole Peters, Adam Pfeiffer, Ian Pitch, Sepp Pitt, Ashley Pomrenke, Sonika Potmas, Evelyn Presnell, Brianna Prince, Caleb Cho, Francesca Query, Logan Quider, Mason Reed, Sophie Reed, Alex Rich, Sophia Robles, Cole Rinowski, Yasmin Safadi, Dana Salisbury, Kayla Salmonen, Anna Schulte, Destiny Scott, Andrew Sedler, Kayla Seitz, Kristen Seckley, Samuel Sinkowski,
Carter Sensabaugh, Bryn Sharrow, Samantha Sherman, Tyler Schuster, Shelby Szymanski, Logan Skinner, Alicia Sleesman, Emma Smith, James Smith, Magdalene Smith, Michaela Smith, Stephen Sommer, Austin Soper, Xavier St. John, Charles Stemler, Lance Stemple, Chloe Stevens, Anna Stoltz, Tess Strebel, Isaac Sugar, Savant Sullivan, Louis Sun, Brandon Swarthout, Ashlyn Swartz, Ethan Swartzenstruber, Rihanna Saeed, Faith Tabler, Brett Taylor, Gabriella Taylor, Emily Telgenhoff, Madison Tenbarge, Mackenzie Thackeray, Jessica Tyson, Haley Thiel, Lauren Phil, Taylor Todd, Evan Trotter Wright, Sophie Ungerleiter, Mark Van Heel, Andrea Vargas, Leah Wager, John Wagner, Margaret Wallace, Abigail Watkins, David Watkins, Rachel Weldy, Christian Whitehead, Samuel Willards, Carly Williams, Allison Wilson, Caitlin Wilson, Gabrielle Wilson, Garrett Wilson, Grace Wilson, Isaiah Wilson, Dana Winslow, Nathan Witt, Skylar Witte, Cortland Wood, Thomas Wood, Kylie Wright, Matthew Wright, Caden York, Sydney Yost, Marissa Zajac, Andrew Sau, Jackson Zener, Dean Zorn.
Thank you. And then wait for everybody to be seated.
Now, I will ask the graduates to please rise. Class of 2021, soak in this moment. This is the last time that we will all be together, people that we have grown up with, and people who have shaped us into who we are today. So, class of 2021, I invite you in joining me of moving your tassel from right to left. Congratulations. I now invite all Dow High School alumni in joining our new alumni in singing the alma mater.
Today we sing our alma mater.
Congratulations, class of 2021. It's just a second, they're going to play the music, and we are going to follow our commencement group out, and then you will follow in your row, one row at a time. So when this row goes out, we're going to go out right down there where it says, where Mrs. Coppins is raising her hands. So you will follow single file right across, and then right out there. So they're going to cue the graduation music, and then we'll be ready to roll, one row at a time. Congratulations.